What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name is David Warren, and this is Day One Tech. And today I got the new DJI Osmo Action 5 Pro. Just going to do an unboxing overview. So on the outside of the box, gives you a couple of the features here. So the features are, you got a 1 1/3 CMOS lens, which pretty much the same. Yeah, here's a big addition that they've added. It's got center track subjects, so it will move around and track a subject. It's got two touch screens, and they're both OLED, so they're nice and bright. They don't use a lot of energy, and they're both touch screens. So most of the other action cameras out there, they only have a touch screen on the front or the back. This one has touch screens on front and back. You'll be able to get about 4 hours of recording time on the battery. That's a great addition. You will be able to hook up the DJI mic 2, so not only just one of them, but two microphones, no adapters, nothing, right out the box, just like on the Pocket 3. And it's got the horizon stable, so it will always keep it right in the center, nice and level. Inside the box, we have the Osmo Action 5 Pro, the extreme battery, a curved adhesive base, a locking screw, protective frame. Here is the unit. One of the other benefits is that they have been staying consistent with the batteries, the form factor. So the 3, the 4, and now the 5 all use the same accessories, connections, the body, they kept it the same. So any of the mounts that you have from the previous ones, you can use on this one. You can also buy an older case and use it on this one. You don't have to buy a brand new case. So everything from my other cameras, I will be able to use. Now, I've had the 1, which was my first action camera that I purchased. I had the 2. The 2 I lost in a adventure at a racetrack. The 3 I traded for the 4, and the 4 I still have. So I still use the 4, probably use the 4 and the 5 so I can get multiple angles on different things. All right, so let's see what else we got in the package here. Here's your USB-C cable. It's a USB-C to C. Now what they do, they've been doing from the 3 to the 4, the 4 to the 5, they're making little changes that add up to a lot. So they'll look at the previous model and say, okay, how can we improve? And I really like that. So here's the case. This is like a little protective case. This does not need a case to go underwater or anything. I could just take this right now and go underwater. Works great. It's completely sealed. But you got this nice little case here. This is probably one of the ruggedest cameras I use. I really enjoy going riding. I can't wait to go like riding on my one wheel and see what it's like at night. All right, so this is your curved mount right here. It's using the standard action. And this is a curved one, so you can put it on the helmet, different things. And these right here are bushings that you can put in there. So when you're tightening this, it gets real tight. So this I will definitely be able to use. And it's got the magnetic connections. So when it's in there, you hear it click. And you have to push in both those buttons to disengage it. And it's got that one. So you can mount it on the bottom with this. And that's where, and this is where the cage comes in, because the cage allows you to mount if you want to do some vertical video and stuff like that. This will allow you to use the action mount to go vertical. I actually have a different cage that I like to use, but it's good to have different options. Okay, next up we have the battery. Batteries are the same form factor from the previous three models. So the 3, the 4, and the 5 all use the same battery. They might have a little bit more space on the battery, let's say, but they all are interchangeable. So if you have one of the previous ones, you don't have to worry about finding batteries. These batteries are really easy to get. Let's see what we have here. There's that nice OLED screen. When you first turn it on, it's going to prompt you to download the app. You can skip this 5 times. I'm going to skip it once. And it takes you through the different modes. Okay, here's a mode that's new to this one. This is a super night mode. I've seen some of the videos of it. It is an improvement. The 4 was good. The 5 Pro is supposed to be even better. So I'm looking forward to checking this out at night. Also allows you to do 4K 120 in your standard video. Photo mode is increased. So now can go to, I believe it is, yeah, here we go, 40 megapixels for the photo. And that's up from 10 on the previous model, so that if you shoot time lapses, this should go real nice. I like shooting time lapses, especially with something like this. I can set it up. It's inconspicuous. It doesn't stand out. And I can shoot a nice long time lapse and then come back, pick it up, and nobody's the wiser. One of the other things that this has that I was really interested in is this, I'm going to call it super slow-mo. So you go into slow motion mode. Most slow motion, you get what's equivalent to 240 frames per second, which is good. And I can get that 120 at 2.7 and 120 at 2.7, which is, yeah. But there's also a higher rate. And what it basically does, once you shoot, then it will use some AI to extend the slow motion. So you can get theoretically up to 960, I believe. So that's going to be interesting to take a look at and see how crisp and clean it is at that higher bit rate. The next thing that this has is it's a tracking mode. So there's a smaller box here and you'll have your subject in that box. And once it's done reframing, you'll be able to have it track whatever's in that box. Good for interviews and talking head videos. I also like this camera because it's fast. You could have it in your pocket or mounted somewhere and you just press, it will turn on and start recording. Other thing I forgot to talk about, it now has internal memory. So you get about 47 gigs of internal memory, which means I don't need to have a card in here to start recording, or if the card's full, which I really like, because there have been times I've had taken footage off and grabbed the camera in a rush to leave and forgot to put the card back in. And I was like, oh no. So that's great. And it's also got the quick charge. So this is always ready to go. Just ready to just pull out, catch something and record. I'm looking forward to setting this up and going out on an adventure and testing it out and seeing how it really works in real life situations. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. Do me a favor, hit that like button for me. and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. I really do appreciate it, and it helps out the channel a lot. So until next video, remember, take care of each other, peace out, and I will see you all soon.